I am Roma Malik, teaching class 11th biology. In the preceding chapters, we have seen there is a variety of living organisms. There are unicellular organisms, there are multicellular organisms. We have also seen that how they vary in the structural organization. In the unicellular organism, a single cell performs all the vital activities, starting from digestion, respiration, reproduction, and other processes. In multicellular organisms, we have seen that they follow a definite pattern, either a cellular level of organization, a tissue level of organization, organ level of organization, or organ system level of organization. There is a division of labor in multicellular organisms, be it from the simple multicellular organisms, the hydra, to the most evolved multicellular organisms, human being. In this episode, we'll be dealing with the unit structural organization in plants and animals, and I'll be dealing with the chapter structural organization in animals. In the previous episode, we have dealt with the structural organization in plants, and in case of animals, we'll find that a multicellular organism is made up of a group of cells which is called the tissue. In animals, there are mainly four types of tissues. They are the epithelial tissues, the connective tissues, the muscular tissues, and the neural tissues. I think we all know that epithelial tissue, it is generally found in our skin. The cells here are compactly packed with little intercellular matrix. There are two types of epithelial tissues. They may be simple as well as compound. The simple epithelium tissues are again divided basing on their shape. Simple epithelium tissues are composed of single layer of cells, and they are found in the lining of our body cavities, just as the ducts, tubes. And basing on the shape, they may be of three types. They may be squamous, they may be cuboidal, they may be columnar. Now, regarding the characteristics of the squamous epithelial tissues, they are a single thin layer of flattened cells, and their boundaries are irregular. That is, they don't have a smooth boundary wall. Example is the wall of the blood vessels, the air sacs of the lungs. The next type of simple epithelium tissue is the cuboidal epithelium tissues. From the name you can make out, these cells are cuboidal in shape. They have a single layer of cube-like cells, and they are found in the ducts of glands and the tubular parts of kidney, that is in the nephrons. Their function is secretion and absorption. Columnar epithelial tissue. They are made up of single layer of cells, and they are slender cells. The nuclei is found at the base, and the free surface has structures called microvilli. From the name only, you can make out that these are columnar shaped, and their function is secretion and absorption. They are found in the lining of stomach and intestine. The columnar and cuboidal cells, they get specialized and act as glandular epithelium. They may be unicellular as well as multicellular. Now, depending on the mode of pouring their secretions into the glands, they are divided into two categories, the exocrine glands and the endocrine glands. The exocrine glands, they secrete the mucus, saliva, earwax through the ducts. So, they are called as the exocrine glands. The endocrine glands, they do not have ducts, and their products are called the hormones. These are directly secreted. These tissues have three types of cell junctions. The first is the tight junction, which stops substances from leaking across a tissue. The second is called the adhering junction, which performs cementing to keep neighboring cells together. And the third is the gap junction, which facilitate the cells to communicate to each other. So, they are distinctly different in their functions and help the tissue as a whole. Compound epithelium tissue is made up of two or more cell layers and they are protective in function. The next type of tissues under the animal tissue category is the connective tissue. Their function is linking and supporting the other tissues and organs of the body. We find three types of connective tissues. These are the loose connective tissues, the dense connective tissues, and the specialized connective tissues. Regarding the loose connective tissues, here the cells and the fibers, they are loosely arranged. For example, the areolar tissue which is found beneath the skin and the adipose tissue which is found beneath the skin, which is responsible for storing fat. In the dense connective tissue, the fibers and fibroblasts are compactly packed. The dense regular orientation of fibers, they show regular pattern, which is seen in the tendons and the ligaments. The dense irregular orientation of fibers shows irregular pattern, which is found in case of the fibroblast and fibers. The specialized connective tissue includes the cartilage, the bones, and the blood. Cartilage tissues, they are enclosed in small cavities within the matrix secreted by them. They are found in the tip of the nose, in our external ear. The bones are made up of calcium salts and collagen fibers. They are made up of bone cells, which are known as osteocytes, and they are present in the spaces called the lacuna. They interact with the skeletal muscles to bring about movements. The bone marrow is the site of production of blood cells. Their function is to give a structural frame to the body and it protects the softer tissues. Blood is the next type of connective tissue. It is a fluid connective tissue consisting of plasma, RBC, WBC, and platelets. Main circulating fluid that helps in the transport of various substances. Let us have a quick recap of the portion we studied in this episode. We studied about the differences in the function of the unicellular and multicellular organisms, the types of animal tissues. They are generally of four types: the epithelial, connective, muscular, neural. The characteristics of the epithelial tissues, the two types of epithelial tissues depending on the number of cell layers present, the simple epithelium and the compound epithelium. Under the simple epithelium, we studied about the squamous, the cuboidal, and the columnar. We also studied about the secretion glands, which are very important, the exocrine gland, which has the ducts, and the endocrine glands, which are known as the ductless glands. The different types of cell junctions, the tight junctions, the adhering junctions, and the gap junctions. Different types of connective tissues, the loose connective tissues, the dense connective tissue, and the specialized connective tissues. In the next episode, we'll be discussing regarding the muscle tissues, the neural tissues, and the morphology and anatomy of certain organisms like earthworm, which comes under Annelida, cockroach, which comes under Arthropoda, and frog, which comes under Amphibia.